thanks and praise, oh God. God, for gathering us, oh God, one more time, oh God, in your name, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. God, we give you glory and we give you honor. Hallelujah. God, we pray for Pastor, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. God, that you would have your way, oh God. God, give her strength and give her courage, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, as she go forth, oh God. God, with your word, oh God. God, to teach us, Lord God. God, look upon Sir Priest, Lord God. Father, have your will, God, within him, Lord. God, give him strength, Lord, in the name of Jesus. God, look upon every member, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. God, look upon everyone, Lord God, that find it not robbery, oh God, to come together, God, to fellowship with you, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. God, God, give them strength, Lord God. Give them courage, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. God, pour a special blessing upon them, in the name of Jesus. God, we look to the hills, Lord God. Father, we know our help come from you, God. For Lord, you created the heavens and the earth, God. God, you created us in your own special will, God. And Father, we want to say we thank you, Lord. We want to say we praise you, oh God, in the name of Jesus. God, look upon every prayer request that have went up before you, oh God, in the name of Jesus. God, you know our every need, hallelujah. Father, we ask you, oh God, to bless, God, in the name of Jesus, oh God. God, have your way, oh God, even on the upcoming election, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we ask you, oh God, to have your way, oh God. Oh God, we put everything, oh God, in your hands, God. Everything, God, in the name of Jesus. God, we ask you to take control, God. Oh God, we leave it up to you, oh God. Oh God, for you, oh God, are the ruler and the maker of us all. We pray, oh God, in Jesus' name, God, we give you glory and we give you honor, oh God. God, for what you're about to do, oh God, on today. Oh God, in Jesus' name, amen and amen.
Praise the Lord, saints. I will be reading John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. The word is already blessed.
God bless you, people of God. We just praise God for you. We thank God for this part of worship, that we can come together and we can get ready to sow our seed. You know, God has been so good to us, and we just want to give back to the Lord and give him what he is due. And we thank God that we can sow our offering and our tithes on this morning. And we just want you to sow a seed on today and know that the Lord will certainly bless you. He will open up the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing. And so on today, we just praise God for even on last week, we were not in worship service, but we were out in the community and we were able to feed families. We fed about 75 families in the community. And we thank God that we were able to have our pantry services. We thank God for the people of God that have just began to even bless us, and people have donated even towards our pantry and our community project. And that is nothing but the goodness of the Lord. So today I'm asking you to sow a seed. We're asking those of you that want to tithe into the ministry, you are going to be sowing and tithing in good ground. And even we're asking those of you that can, we have been asking over the last couple of weeks for a donation of $37. As some of you know, we had some damage to our sanctuary, had some damage to our carpet and our chairs, and we've had to replenish those things and buy 174 chairs, and they are on their way to be shipped, but we're just asking. You know, the Bible said just to ask and you shall receive. And we thank God for all of the people of God that have been blessing. I'm telling you, the blessings have been coming in. People have been pouring into our bosom and have helped us with this circumstance that we are in. But we praise God because truly the Lord is turning it around for our good. And so we just want to tell you, thank you, all of those that have purchased. They donated one chair, two chairs. Some have donated five. Some have even donated 10 chairs. And we don't take it for granted, but we thank God because He is meeting the need through you. He is meeting the need through the people of God. So we want you to get your offering in your hand, and we're going to pray over it. You can sow your seed by using the Givelify app, and you will see it on the screen. You can go to the church website and get the Givelify app, and it's a safe, secure way to sow your seed on today. Or you can even mail it to our P.O. Box. Amen. Our P.O. Box is right on the screen there. And so let's get our offering in our hand on today. And we're just going to pray a blessing over you. Heavenly Father God, we thank you for the seed that you have given us to sow on today. We thank you, oh God, Lord God, that we know that it does not belong to us. But we know, oh God, that when we give, we cannot beat your giving. Hallelujah. We thank God that you will return it to your people 100-fold, 1,000-fold. And Lord, we ask you to bless, God, everything that comes into this ministry for the upbuilding of the kingdom. Bless each and every one on today. Every need, oh God, let it be met. And we declare these things in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Just
Anybody get that message? Don't pray and worry. What is the sense in praying if you're going to worry about it? We thank God that we are giving it all to our Lord and Savior on today. We welcome you on this morning to another worship service with Great Emmanuel Temple. So happy that you decided to join us. And we just pray that your soul is being blessed on today. God is a good God. Yes, He is. And no, we are not going to worry. We're going to give it all to Him. So on this morning, we're coming to you from the book of Matthew. We want you to get your Bibles, gather around with your family, and turn with us to Matthew chapter 7. And we're going to read verses 7 and 8. Amen. We'll be reading from the King James Version. And the word of the Lord says, "Ask, and it shall be given you. Seek, and ye shall find. Knock, and it shall be open unto you. For everyone that asketh, receiveth. And he that seeketh, findeth. And to him that knocketh, it shall be open." Can somebody say amen? Hallelujah. We praise God. My message on this morning is A-S-K. Ask, seek, and knock. Hallelujah. You know, just like the My Ministry came forth a little while ago and said, don't worry, you know, just pray about it. Don't worry. And we have the formula on today. The Word of God is telling us three simple things that we have to do. Ask, seek, and knock. And these three words, they include the ideas of want, loss, and earnestness. So we're asking something because we want something from God. And it's His pleasure to give it to us on today. You know, the Lord loves it when we come to Him and we let Him know that we need Him. And He said, just ask and you shall receive. And you know, He said also seek. So when you think about that, what am I seeking for, or why am I seeking? So it must be something that I want. It must be something that I need. Is it something that I lost? I'm seeking to find it again. But the Word of God said, he that seeks, he shall find it. And then He says to knock. So when I'm knocking, I am knocking in earnest. You know, sometimes when we're in a rush and there's an emergency and we want somebody to open the door, we just bang on that door, open the door. And this is what we are talking about on today. You know, when we go to God and we ask Him, you know, He wants us to ask Him. And sometimes we have to ask repeatedly. Don't feel bad and don't feel shame if you keep coming to God and you ask Him over and over again. You know, this is what He wants His children to do. So we ask repeatedly until we get an answer. You know, our mothers used to tell us, don't stop praying. There's a song we used to sing, saints, don't stop praying. The Lord is nigh. Don't stop praying because He will hear your cry. And so we ask the Lord earnestly, not carelessly, but we're asking Him. And then when we talk about seeking, you know, the Word of God said, seek and you shall find. And so when we're seeking something, to seek something is stronger even than to ask. You know, I've asked you, and now I'm seeking. I'm seeking for the answer. This I'm going to do by myself. You know, when we seek God, we can't rely on someone else to seek God for us. But we've got to seek Him for ourselves. And then when you talk about knocking at the door, it's sort of like the beggar at the door. Yes, you know, the world sings that song, "Ain't Too Proud to Beg." I'm not too proud to go to God and let Him know that I need you. Hallelujah. I need you, Lord. I need you. Every hour I need you. And so we keep knocking and we keep seeking until we get an answer from God. And you know, faith in your prayer is the key that will unlock the door. So somebody say faith. Type it on the screen. I've got to have faith on today. And so we're talking about asking, we're talking about seeking, and we're talking about knocking until the Lord answers. And so I want to take a look on this morning. Let's look at Elisha and the Shunammite woman. You know the story of this prophet and the Shunammite, the widow woman. And so in that, we need to go to 2 Kings. If you go to 2 Kings and look in chapter 4, it tells of this story. And we know how there was a prophecy that was fulfilled, and this woman did not have a child, and she told the prophet, you know, wanted to know what he could do for this Shunammite woman because she had taken care of him so well, and she did not have a child. And so he told her, he said, by this time next year, you are going to have a child. And so we know the story, and I'm not going to tell that whole story of those things that happened, but the prophecy came forth, hallelujah, and we thank God that this woman had a son. And some years later, we go over to verse 18, and we see some events that took place, and I want to read some of those scriptures on today, from starting at verse 18. And it says, when the child was grown, it fell on a day that he went out to his father's house. He went out to his father's in the field. And he said to his father, he said, my father, he said, my head, my head. And some say he may have had a sunstroke. And so his father called to another young man and told him, he said, carry him to his mother. Take him back to his mother. And so when they took the son back to his mother, they sat the son on her knees. And they sat there until high noon, and then the son died. Hallelujah. So now there's the promise that died. And so this woman is getting ready to go into some action because she still believed God. And so what she did was she went up and she took her child and she laid him on the bed of the man of God. And that's what it says in the word. She didn't just take him and lay him anywhere, but she knew where to take her son. And sometimes when we get in a predicament and we've got a crisis, we've got an emergency, we need to know exactly where to take our problems to. And we know that we got to go straight to God and take them to God. Hallelujah. And so this woman, she took her son and she laid him on Elisha's bed. And the word of God said that she shut the door upon him and she went out. And so here's a door that has been shut. And just like we read in the scripture, it said that if you knock, that the door shall be open. And there was a process that was taking place. So now we've got the son that's dead laying on the bed of the prophet, and the door is shut. And so the word of God says she called to her husband, and she said, send me one of your strong young men and get your donkey and let me go. She said that I may run to the man of God. She was not going to walk. She was not going to skip. She said, I may run to the man of God. And so now here's the earnestness that comes, you know, into play. She has an issue. She's got an emergency. And so she's asking. She told her husband, she said, let me go. And now she's lost something precious, you know, something that is dear to her. And so she's getting ready to go and seek out the man of God. She said, I've got to find the man of God. And in those days, you know, the people knew that the prophets were so close to God. And if they said a prayer, that God would hear them and answer their prayer. And so down in verse 23, she the servant that was getting ready to take her to the man of God, he said to her, he said, wherefore will you go to him today? In other words, why are you going to him today? It's not a new moon. It's not the Sabbath. And so why are you seeking out the prophet today? And she said, it shall be well. I need somebody to say with me, it shall be well. Hallelujah. Her faith was being put into action. Now, you know, when we have a crisis, and if we were in this woman's predicament, in her shoes, and your son died, what would your reaction be? You know, would you be able to say, it shall be well? You know, she didn't sit there. She didn't have a pity party. And there's nothing wrong with crying and weeping because we're human. We're in our humanity. But this Shunammite woman, immediately, She put her son on the bed of the man of God. She shut that door and she said, I've got to go and find the prophet. And so the young man that was getting ready to take her on the journey, you know, she told him, she said, it shall be well. This woman had nothing but positive things to say. She had nothing but faith coming out of her lips. Now, hallelujah, this is the first time that she said this. And so the word of God says she got on the donkey and she said to her servant, she said, drive and go forward. She said, slack not your riding for me. So that lets me know she put her seatbelt on and she said, let's go, let's hit the gas. Hallelujah. She said, you don't have to go slow and worry about me going all over the place, worrying about me feeling the bump. She's like, we're on a mission. We've got to go. I am seeking, hallelujah, seeking out the man of God. And that's how we got to be on today. When we've got a crisis, we got to go before God and seek his face by any means necessary. So she got on that donkey and she went, hallelujah, and she told the young man, she said, don't slow down unless I tell you to. Amen. Can't slow down. So the word of God, I'm in verse 25, it says that she went and she came unto the man of God. And so the man of God, he saw her afar off coming. And so he sent someone to her and to ask her, you know, what's the problem? Is everything okay? Is it well with thee? He said, is it well with your household? Is it well with your husband? Is it well with your child? And she answered. She answered those same three words. She said, it is well. I'm telling you, she was speaking in faith. You know, her faith was in action. She was calling those things that were not as though they were. And this is what the word of God tells us that we have to do. Yes, my son is laying up there dead. You know, he's behind closed doors. He's in a shut up room. But I know that all is well because I know who I serve. I know that this prophet is a man of God, and I know that he's going to be able to reach God for me. Oh God, I bless you. And so we've got to know when we are up against, you know, our backs are up against the wall, we've got to keep a praise on our lips and just speak it into the atmosphere. All is well. It is well. It shall be, and it is. Hallelujah. So her faith was still in action. And so we go down to verse 27, and it says, when she came to the man of God, she caught him by the feet. But the servant Gehazi, he came near her and he wanted to thrust her away. The word of God said he wanted to move her and push her to the side. Hallelujah. You know, so many times people will try to push you to the side, just like the woman with the issue of blood, how she pressed through the crowd and the men turned around and they wanted to push her away. Don't let anybody stop you from getting to God. Don't let anything stop you from getting to God. Hallelujah. Because this is an emergency. Lord, I need you right now. And so the man of God, Elisha, said, leave her alone. You know, he said, leave her alone. He said, I can see that her soul is vexed. I can see that she's got an issue. I can see that she needs something. You know, this is not just a woman coming to get on my nerves. He said, but there's something wrong. Hallelujah. And so she was just, you know, she was just knocking at this point. She asked, hallelujah, and then she was seeking. She found the man of God, and now she's knocking. You know, importunity. Sometimes we've got to show importunity. And what do I mean about that? That means persistence. You know, got to be persistent, even to the point of being annoying. I don't care if I'm getting on your nerves. Hallelujah. Oh, don't you know you can never get on the nerves of God? You can't get on him when you're going to him and you're asking him for something. So we got to be persistent. You know, God, here I am again. Lord God, I'm in your face once again. You know, people get tired of us. They get tired of hearing our issues. They get tired of hearing our needs, and sometimes we complain. Hallelujah. But I praise God that the Lord God, He will not turn His ear from you. Oh God. So she knocked, and she told the man of God, she said, I need you to come. And so down to verse 32, so the man of God, he went, hallelujah. And it says, when Elijah came into the house, that the child was dead. Now, all this time, she kept saying, it is well. She told Elisha, she said, it is well, hallelujah. But when he came, and he even said that the Lord had hid this thing from him. You know, I'm a prophet. God, why didn't you tell me ahead of time that the young man was sick? Why didn't you tell me that he had died? Oh, but God has a plan that was coming together. And so when he got to the house, he saw that the child was dead. And he saw that the child was laying on his bed. And the word of God said that he went in verse 33, and said he went in, and what did he do? He shut the door. Hallelujah. Once again, that door is still shut. God didn't open it yet. It's still shut. But how many know that He's working behind the scenes? Oh, God. And the word of God says that Elijah, he prayed unto the Lord. So here, he's praying. He's got to ask God himself. All right. So now we've got the prophet. He's got to ask, seek, and knock. Hallelujah. And so the word of God says that Elijah went up and he laid upon the child. And he put his mouth to his mouth. He put his eyes to his eyes. And he put his hands upon his hands and stretched himself upon the child. So here he was seeking God earnestly. And it said that the flesh of the child began to get warm. Life began to come into that child. And so even on today, I want you to be encouraged today. Don't stop seeking God. Don't stop praying. It doesn't matter how people may say, oh, you're being foolish. Don't even worry about how you look or what people are saying, but know that God is working. Hallelujah. There's a time, you know, the God's timing. We don't know what His time is. You know, He allowed this child to die. He didn't have to let, He could have raised this boy up when he was laying on his mother's knees, but He allowed the child to die. And so many times we might say, well, God, this thing is dead. You know, there's no life in this situation. There's no life in what I'm going through. It looks like a dead thing. You know, it even begins to smell like death. Hallelujah. Oh, but we praise God. The word of God said that when Elijah laid himself on top of this young man, oh God, that life began. His flesh began to warm up, and somebody's situation is beginning to warm up. There is life that is happening in the situation. And sometimes we don't always see it. You know, it still looks dead, but underneath the surface, there is life that is coming forth. And so Elijah, it said, after the his flesh started to warm up, it said, then Elijah, he went out again, and then he went back in, and he returned. And sometimes, you know, you got to keep going to God. This is like his third time that he's coming in, and he returned. And it says that he walked in the house, hallelujah, and he began to pace to and fro. You know, he began to pace the floor a little bit. And yes, sometimes you got to pace the floor, and that's okay. It's all right. But don't worry and pray. Hallelujah. You know, you can pray, but don't worry. You know, sometimes we begin to pace the floor. And so the word of God said he went up again and stretched himself across the child. And what happened? The child sneezed. Not one time, not two times, but he sneezed seven times. And that number seven means completion. The work was done. God had did the work. And we praise God for that. And the word of God says that he opened up his eyes. And so the servant called the Shunammite woman, and she went in, and she went in and opened the door. So now that door that was shut, that door that Elijah had shut, and that door that the woman had shut, now that same door was open. And the word of God said that she went in, to the open door and fell at the prophet's feet. And then she took her son up and went out. Hallelujah. So ask, seek, and knock. Somebody put that on the screen. Ask God, seek him, and knock. Those are some things that we're going to have to do. Some things, hallelujah, we know some things come by prayer and fasting, and there's some yokes that have to be broken. There are some chains that have to be broken. Some yokes have to be destroyed. But we've got to do what the Word of God tells us to do. Oh, God, I bless you. Hallelujah. And so I want you to go to John 5, 14 and 15. The Word of God says this, and this is the confidence that we have in him. You can rest assured in this thing. This is the confidence that we have in him. He said that if we ask anything, anything according to his will, what will happen? The Word of God said that he hears us. Ask anything according to his will. Lord, if it's your will, let it be done. Lord, let your will be done. Ask according to his will. And if we know, hallelujah, you got to know. That means your faith's got to be on point. You've got to have your faith intact. Stretch that faith, you know, exercise that faith. And if we know that he hears us, and how do we know that he hears us? Because he said he hears us. Whatsoever we ask, we know that we have the petitions that we desired of him. And I praise God for this on today. Hallelujah. Because there are so many things that we have before the Lord. I am quite sure there's some things that you got before the Lord. Some stuff that you have been asking him to do. And so now, you know, he has not answered. It has not come forth. It has not been manifested. But have you started seeking? Have you really started seeking God? Sometimes we got to get rid of all the distraction. We've got to steal away. And we've got to seek the Lord's face. You know, we've got to go before God, turn our plates down, push that plate away, close that refrigerator, and we've got to seek the Lord. Go into your secret closet. You know, I'm still away. Get away from everybody and everything. Lord, I'm seeking you. And as I seek you, I'm seeking you day by day. When I go in my car, when I'm doing my chores and I'm going about doing my errands, Lord, I'm still seeking your face. That's what's so wonderful about prayer on today, that we don't have to always be on our knees. We don't have to always be in a position of prayer, because we can't always be. But thank God that there is a prayer wheel that's turning on the inside, and nobody can shut up that prayer wheel. That enemy can't even shut up that prayer wheel. Just like Hannah, when she was praying and they thought that she was drunk, hallelujah, she didn't utter a sound, just her lips were moving, and nobody knew what she was saying. But you can keep that prayer wheel going when you are in the supermarket, when you're on your job, when you're in school. You know, the teachers are looking at you, and you're online virtually, and sometimes you can mute that button and they can't hear what you're saying, but you can just start moving your lips and pray. Even as you're going, sitting there taking a test, just begin to pray. Hallelujah. And so this is what is so awesome about prayer, that we've got this communication with God. And so he said, ask me. And he said, if you ask me, he said, you shall receive. You know, all you got to do is ask. Sometimes we don't get what we need from God. Sometimes we don't get what we want. We're afraid to ask him. You know, you can ask, hallelujah, ask the Savior to help you. Ask him. Tell him what you need. Tell him all about it. And so he said to ask. He said, and then you seek me. If you seek me, you surely will find. Hallelujah. You know, he doesn't have us out here seeking, playing hide and seek. But I know when I seek the Lord, I'm going to receive. I'm going to find that thing that I'm looking for. And then he said to knock. Hallelujah. Somebody needs to knock earnestly. You know, don't go with a little light knock. Sometimes people are in the house and they can't hear you. And you start banging on that door. Let me in. Open up the door. Open up the door. And so this is how it is in the spirit. We want God to open that door. And how many believe that God is opening the door for you? I believe that he's going to open the door. And we know, hallelujah, that no man can shut that door that God is going to open for you. Oh God, you've got to believe him on today. You know, just encourage yourself. Have faith in God. Don't lose your faith, saints. No matter how hard it looks, no matter how hopeless that thing looks, don't lose your faith. Just know that God is with you. Know that God is on your side. You know, when we ask God to save our family, to deliver our family, we ask God for our healing. Just keep seeking God. Hallelujah. And just keep saying, all is well. All is well. I don't care if it don't look well. All is well anyhow. You know how sometimes we'll go to someone and we see one of our friends and we say, hi, how you doing? And sometimes you'll say, I'm blessed and highly favored, or I'm fine. And you may not be fine, but you don't want people to really know what it is you're going through. So you tell them, I'm fine. And you know, you put on that smile, and sometimes it's a fake smile. That's okay if it's a fake smile, but keep faking it. You know, we say, keep faking it until you make it. Keep faking it until it comes a reality. She, you know, even though this woman said all is well, in her heart, I know her heart was heavy, and I know that she may have been crying on the inside, but she said all is well, because I know that God is getting ready to take care of this situation. All is well. Hallelujah. So we praise God on today. We thank God for the word. You know, just ask. A-S-K. That's the formula. Ask, seek, and knock. Don't stop. Don't listen to that enemy that tells you, you know, stop asking God. He's not going to do it for you. The devil is a liar. Hallelujah. Just keep asking him. And let me tell you something. If it's his will, he'll do it. And if it's not his will, then it's not going to be done. And you know what, saints? If it's not his will, then you don't want it to happen. You know, we want the will of God to be manifested in our life. Lord, I don't want this if this is not your will, because it's not, maybe it's not good for you. Maybe it's not the right timing. So let's learn how to trust the will of God. Let's learn how to trust the leading of God. Let's learn how to trust, you know, our steps that are ordained and ordered by the Lord. Hallelujah. So on this morning, we just want you to be encouraged on today. We want you to know that God said, if you ask me, hallelujah, I'll do it for you. If you seek me, hallelujah, you'll find it. And if you knock, the door will be open. So on today, we just want to offer up a word of prayer with you on today. And we want to even invite someone that does not know the Lord Jesus Christ as their Savior. This is the formula. Hallelujah. And you say, well, I don't know the Lord Jesus Christ and a pardon of my sins, but I want to know him. I want a change in my life. I want God to come into my life. So all you got to do is ask him. Hallelujah. If you want it, just ask. Hallelujah. And he will come in and turn your life around. He will come in and just forgive you, clean you up, forgive you of your sins, change your mind, give you a new mindset. All you got to do is throw up your hands and surrender all and ask him. And then he said, seek me. And so we seek the Lord. You know, seek God. God, I need to find out more about you. There's so much that we don't even know about God. So we're seeking God. We're seeking his ways. Hallelujah. And he said, knock, and the door will be open. So, you know, let's just allow God to come into our lives. Let's allow God to do the work that he wants to do in our lives. Heavenly Father God, we thank you for these your people on this morning. God, we thank you for your word on today. And Lord, we are coming to you obeying your word. You told us, God, that if we ask, that if we seek and look for you earnestly, hallelujah, if we knock earnestly, God, that you will open up the door. And we thank you, oh God, because someone needs a door open on today. Somebody, oh God, needs you, oh God, to make a way. Somebody, oh God, needs you to make their pathway straight. Lord God, to clear open the passageway. And Lord, we are claiming victory on today. And God, we ask you, Lord, to even look on those that do not know you in the pardon of their sins, that do not know you as their personal Savior. God, we ask you, Lord, just to fill them even right now as they lift their hands and surrender to you. Fill them, oh God, with your love. Wrap your arms around them in the mighty name of Jesus. And God, we give you praise and we give you glory in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. So we just praise God for you being with us once again. We thank God for your support. We thank God for your prayers. We praise God, amen, just for all that he is doing. And we want you just to have a blessed day on today. We want you to have a blessed week, amen. Just know that all is well. I don't care how it looks right now, but just continue to say, all is well. It is well with my soul.